Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to now the final stretch of this conference. I think, although each of us could only participate in some of the aspects of the discussion, it became very clear that the debate on regulatory reform so far has been marked by a heavy emphasis on the use of instruments, and not so much on the question of strategy, maybe with some countries leading here. But my sense was really that we have to look beyond the use of the instruments as a real challenge as we look forward. And we have to ask the question, what happens once standard cost models work, or once we have a good understanding of what risk assessment and risk management can really contribute? In other words, what are the next steps? And I'd really like to use this last session of the conference to serve us three purposes. One is to get another political point of view, like we got it last night from the Bundestagspräsident Dr. Lammert, on the interaction between also the political priorities and regulatory reform. And there we are very happy to have Prime Minister Pavlak as a guest. I'll introduce him in a minute. Secondly, we are grateful that four rapporteurs have more or less volunteered to try to summarize from their point of view what has been the most important insights. And finally, I'd like to use the time that is left before 4 o'clock. We'll finish punctually, I promise, to discuss with the other members of the podium what they think should be next steps, also with regard to this community and to the issues that have been raised. In essence, I think we are at a point where many dilemmata have surfaced as a result of the discussions in the last days, yesterday and today. And it seems to me that they can only be resolved within a broader picture of modern regulation, regulatory reform that includes the perspective of the public administration as well as the political perspective. And it seemed to me very much that we had something like a convergence on terms like we need to affect or think about the culture of regulation on both sides. We need to think about the mindset. I think that is a term that Norbert Lammert used. And at the same time, I think in one of the sessions this morning, the Andrew van der Lem said, it's bloody complicated. And I think that feeling is left with me also after all of listening to many of the discussions. So how do we deal with this complexity, with this bloody complicated world? If especially at the heart of it is a mindset change that we need to address. And before we get started now in the afternoon in more seriousness, let me quote Einstein, because in a way, theoretical physics is also bloody complicated. He had a very interesting view on simplicity. And if I quote it correctly from memory, Einstein once said he would give his life for simplicity beyond complexity. He wouldn't give a fig, nothing at all, for simplicity this side of complexity. So I think it's the same with regulation. It's an art form where if you end up with simplicity that is this side of the complexity, we may actually not achieve much. If we somehow manage to transcend complexity, to reach a level of simplicity or of architectural elegance, as I said in my introductory statement, beyond on the other side of complexity, a lot can be achieved. So let me start now the discussion by introducing the Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of the Economy for the Republic of Poland, Mr. Waldemar Pawlak. Welcome. Mr. Pawlak is... I think it's fair to say Mr. Pawlak is among the most famous Polish politicians in the last 20 years. He has been a member of the same the Polish parliament since 1989. From 1993 to 1995, he served as the prime minister for the Republic of Poland. Moreover, from 1991 to 1997, he was the chairman of the Polish People's Party, a position which he took up again in 2005 and still holds today. From 2001 to 2005, he was the president of the board of the Warsaw Commodities Exchange. And finally, after the successful election campaign, he took over the position of vice prime minister and minister of the economy in the government headed by the new Polish Prime Minister Donald Tusk, who is currently in Berlin in the meeting with the Chancellor Angela Merkel, which I think we all are very happy about. Mr. Pawlak comes to us directly from the meeting with our Minister of Economy, Mr. Kloss. We are very grateful, Mr. Prime Minister, that you are here. It's a very special honor for us that you take the time in your busy schedule to spend time with us at the International Regulatory Reform Conference. We've got four rapporteurs, four work streams. The first work stream, as you all know, was about measuring and reducing red tape. It has been attended by Jérôme Nyland, head of the Dutch Regulatory Reform Group, formerly known as IPAL. The second work stream was about evidence-based policy making and will be summarized by Andrea Renda, the Senior Research Fellow at the Center for European Policy Studies, and Mr. Edward Donnellan, Senior Advisor for Regulatory Governance at the OECD, will focus on the third working stream on governing regulatory reform. And last but not least, I'm looking forward to another story about the clown Bonzo by Andrew van der Lem, Deputy Director of the British Better Regulation Executive. Now, without further ado, I turn to Mr. Nyland. If you take the floor and give us your insights, what you took away from the sessions.